Right then, let's see if this is working, shall we? Just back off the throttle lock a little. That sounds like it's tripping rather badly, or looks like it with it all in the red, but never mind. No, throttle lock just don't work, does it? Never mind. Off to the tunnel. Plan was to go and meet Finn in Budapest on my wonderful 1290. The adjective wonderful there is a little preemptive, and you'll notice past tense, the plan was. I'm now sat astride my Transalp because the 1290 is broken. Friday afternoon I took it out to put the final few miles on it before the first service yesterday, and the oil pressure light came on. Big red warning on the dash. So managed to get the bike recovered and sent back to Loughborough to Redline KTM, who have been absolutely wonderful in this, what is essentially a complete shit show though, with this bike. But bottom line is, I'm going to reject the bike. I don't want it repaired. There's no way I want to be going anywhere near a bike that's got an oil pressure issue in the first 6 days. So I need to start the process of getting my money back. This all sounds very familiar. If I ever post this on YouTube, probably won't. But this all sounds very familiar, doesn't it? You know, I've seen a lot of other people with this. You know, the only fortunate thing that I've got, fortunate, if that's such a thing in a situation like this, is that I'm within the 14 days. I'm not sure it's 14 or 30, but I'm within the 6 days old. So the bottom line is I can just turn around and say, and reject the bike and get a full refund, no quibble, which is what I'm going to do, because the bike was purchased purely for this trip, for this year. Obviously, not just for this trip, but I brought it this year for this trip. If I wasn't doing this trip, I wouldn't have bought it this year. I'd have waited until next year for one. But yeah, consequently, and I'm going to see if I've got the tunnel was already booked, accommodation tonight was booked, and Monday night was booked. Budapest is already booked, but I don't think I'm going to be making it to Budapest on this. The bike is more than capable of making it to Budapest. I, however, on this bike, with no cruise and no ability to stretch out a little bit more and rest, you know, it's just, it's going to be a bit tedious, to say the least. And at the end of the day, it's a holiday. It's supposed to be a holiday, not an endurance test. So anyway, miserableness out of the way, I'm on the bike, it's packed, overpacked of course, because that's standard, and I'm on my way on the M40 to the tunnel. So I've got a 4:15 train, but I am doing the usual thing of just hoping to jump on something a little earlier, because I've got another 3 hours the other side to my hotel in Reims, Reims. We'll see how it goes, see how I feel by the time I get to the tunnel. That's going to be a good indication of how doable this bike is going to be for this trip. But anyway, I'm going to sign off there, because who on earth wants to watch me riding down the motorway? Nobody. That's the answer to that one. I'm back again, still on the M25. That feeling you get when you're filtering towards stationary traffic, because it's just getting slower and slower and tighter and tighter. Oh, I hope there's not a blockage up here. I'm going to turn you off because it's now started pissing rain. It's right now that I am so pleased that I've got the Gore-Tex on. Otherwise, even now, I'll be starting to get wet in the jeans, and there's nowhere for me to stop. get an ambulance in London? I mean, God, what a nightmare. Bring them back.
Thank you.
would you just look at that somewhat foreboding sky in front. I do hope we don't get caught by that. But we shall see. We shall see. I may very well just be stopping. Let's put the cover on the phone at least. Well, I am either going to be back here in 3 or 4 days, or I will be back here in 2 weeks, maybe. We shall see. I'm hoping the 2 weeks, because that means I'll have seen Finn. But I don't think that's likely, unfortunately. You never know. You never know. Feeling good, though. Everything's aching. No, not everything's aching. Things are right. Everything that I expect to be aching is aching, but not to unbearable levels, which is good. So, let's see how we get on. Really nice if I didn't get wet for the duration of this journey down to Reims. Really nice. That's probably asking a bit much. Come on, don't get me wet all the way there, please. Right, well, this is going to get about as boring as you can possibly imagine, isn't it? So we shall turn this off now until I feel like talking shit about something.